Good morning, Davao. Good morning, Mindanao. Good morning, North, South, East, and West. This is Gilbert Lopez Martihicatso for the headlines. Weather forecast. Easterlies affecting Mindanao. Local news. Vintage bomb found in Panabo City. Rescue dog in Davao. Police now have leads on Kibuloy's whereabouts. Kaap Davao addresses public concerns, bears budget challenges. National news. Government employees to receive mid-year bonuses by May 15. Marcos negative for cocaine use in 2021. International news. Four dead in protest against flour and energy prices. Vladimir Putin removes Sergei Shoigu from Russian Defense Ministry. Entertainment news. Paul Mescal among stars at Gucci show. Sky Garden performs at the Howlers Manila. Two cosplay and music festival. For the sports news, huwag tayong titigil mangarap. Sisi Rondina encourages Choco Mozzo to continue pursuit the breakthrough PBL little title. England recall fit again bright for Euro qualifiers. Featured stories. The U.S. founding father who traveled the globe, age is just a number. 81-year-old man conquers highest peak, Philippine peak. Side story and trivia. Do you know that Davao City is known for its tight-knit and diverse communities? Weather forecast. Mindanao will be partly cloudy to cloudy skies with isolated rain showers and thunderstorms due to easterlies. Light to moderate winds from east to northeast with slight to moderate seas. Local news. The Panabo City Police Authorities recovered an exploded, corroded vintage bomb after a laborer reported finding a bomb while he was working in a plantation area on Friday afternoon, May 9, 2024. In a spot report provided by Panabo City Police Office, Tactical Operations Center TOC, the unexploded explosive ordnance UEO CTG 81mm was reported to them by one Brian Dungilla or Dungila, a farm laborer at Purok 5, Barangay Little Panay. As of press writing, the bomb is currently under the care of the police agency in collaboration with the Explosive Ordnance Disposal Team for further investigation and disposition. This is not the first time that the authorities in Panabo City have responded to bomb-related incidents. To recall, police authorities reported an explosion executed by two unidentified suspects. After the landslide in Masara that highlighted APPA. The rescue dog who aided the rescuers in finding a live toddler beneath the mound of earth. Nothing had been said about the other rescue dog who were there present and helping in the search and rescue or retrieval of the bodies. Among the rescue canines who were there were the dog of Dorian Dog Squad Incorporated, DDS, formed by individuals of different backgrounds but with one common denominator, their love for dogs. SF02 Rosler Langnayo Jr., one of the dog owners in DDS, narrated how the number conceptualized the idea of becoming volunteer rescues themselves with their dogs. Renisme Rommel and Spear are all Belgians, Malinois, while Snappy is an American Pit Bull Terrier. Lagnayo said his dog, an American Pit Bull Terrier, seems unlikely to be a trained to save lives with a breed that is more known to be aggressive and much better for guarding properties and their owners. The Philippine National Police PNP already has a hint on the whereabouts of fugitive televangelist Pastor Apollo Kiboloy after they received partial information from their tracker team. However, despite of good leads, the police central office and other security team have yet to verify the full information so as not to jeopardize the ongoing manhunt operation. They also declined to provide the exact time frame when they could capture the infamous preacher. On the other hand, Police Regional Office Davao PRO Davao also said that they are still going to continue the conduct of an intensive search against the founder of the Kingdom of Jesus Christ, KJC, and his co-accused followers. PRO Davao spokesperson Catherine Delaray said that they are operating nonstop to locate Kiboloy since the leader was served with a warrant of arrest for his non-bailable human trafficking cases. For this month alone, a lot has happened to Kiboloy's situation. An official from Civil Aviation Authority of the Philippines Davao Region, CAAF Davao, acknowledged the need for improvements at the Francisco Bangoy International Airport, also known as Davao International Airport, DIA. Rex Obsina, CAAP, Davao's manager, expressed regret for the inconvenience caused to the public due to the lack of significant airport enhancement during the 20th City Council session on Tuesday morning, May 7, 2024. He said, "The significant improvements requires a budgetary allocation which is beyond the scope of the CAAP Davao region." Addressing specific concerns raised by Davao City Mayor Sebastian Baste Duterte and Councilor Alrayan Alejandre, CAAP Davao has taken steps to address issues promptly. National news. Qualified government employees will receive their mid-year bonuses starting May 15, 2024. The Department of Budget and Management, DBM, said Tuesday, May 14, 2024. The amount of the mid-year bonus is equal to 1 month basic pay. In order to qualify, employees should be in a government service for at least 4 months from July 1, 2023 to May 15, 2024. It includes civilian personnel, regular, casual, and contractual employees, and full or part-time appointed or elected or elective positions in governments, branches, or institutions such as executive, legislative, and judicial branches, constitutional, commissional, or commissions, or constitutional office, state universities and colleges, SUCs, government-owned or controlled corporations, GOCCs, which is covered by the Compensation and Position Classification System, CPCS, as well as local government units, or LGU. President Ferdinand Bongbong Marcos Jr. has tested negative for cocaine use in November 2021. A drug analysis from the St. Luke Medical Center, Global City, said on Monday, May 13, 2024. Drug analyst Gereza Reyes and drug testing laboratory head Dr. Cecilia Lim, who both signed Marcos' cocaine test result, testified during the resumption of the Senate Committee on Public Order and Dangerous Drug Inquiry into the alleged leak of confidential information from the Philippine Drug Enforcement Agency, or PDEA. Lim said the result was out after the 2 minutes and 54 seconds after the test was conducted. Committee Chairperson Ronald De La Rosa raised an eyebrow as he sought clarity on why Marcos was tested for cocaine. International news. 4 people have died and 100 others were left wounded after violent clashes with authorities in Pakistan administered Kashmir. Thousands of people have been on the streets since Friday to protest rising prices of flour and electricity. Organizers called off the protest on Tuesday, a day Pakistan's PM Shehbaz Sharif offered subsidies worth 24 billion rupees. Mr. Mir had also demanded that the government offer financial compensation for the families of those killed in the violence. Violence had intensified since the weekend, prompting authorities to cut mobile services. Schools, public transportation, and businesses have also been suspended. Russian President Vladimir Putin is to remove his long-standing ally Sergei Shoigu as defense minister, the Kremlin has announced. The 68-year-old had been in a role since 2012 and will be replaced by Deputy Prime Minister Andrew Belousov and economist with little military experience. Mr. Shoigu is to be appointed Secretary of Russia's Secretary Council. The Kremlin said the defense ministry needed to stay, innovate, reshuffle in Russia don't happen very often, so this is a big moment at the top of Russian politics. But Vladimir Putin remains the person who ultimately calls the shot. It was his decision to start the war in Ukraine, and all the big decisions are taken by him. The appointment of Mr. Belousov as defense minister will come as a surprise to many, given his previous experience. But analysts suggest President Putin is seeking to align the Russian economy more closely with the war effort. Entertainment news. The concrete basement of London's Tate Modern was transformed into a green jungle on Monday for Gucci's latest fashion show. An elite audience included Paul Mescal, Dua Lipa, Andrew Scott, and Salma Hayek watched as models displayed the new collection of the runway. The luxury Italian fashion house showed a variety of delicate sheer outfit, relaxed denims, and casual streetwear. Many models also sported matched leather bags with the company's famous Double G logo. The collection was the latest from Sabato De Sarno, who became Gucci's creative director last year. Gucci normally shows collection as part of the Milan Fashion Week, but it often chooses other locations around the world for its cruise collection, those in between the main spring and autumn fashion weeks. At Monday's show, models walked between hundreds of ferns, plants, and mossy pots, a look which contrasted with the industrial show space. Japanese trio Sky Garden was surprised by the energy of Filipinos who joined them throughout their performances at the recently concluded music event, Howlers Manila, Two Cosplays and Musical Festival at Circuit Makati. The Sky Garden heated the Howlers Manila stage with their electrifying performances. The trio had so much fun that they considered it as one of the most memorable events that happened in their group. Sky Garden performed along with Ellie Buendia, Silent Sanctuary, Mayonnaise, Yara, Kiaya, YNO, First One, Flow G, and Al James, among others. And for the sports, CC Rondina firmly believes that Chocomotso's time to capture a breakthrough title in the Premier Volleyball League will eventually come. A Creamline-Chocomotso title dreams anew. CC Rondina turned to the rest of the Flying Titans, gently tapping her chin with the back of her hand. It was an act of encouragement, urging her teammates to hold their heads. And despite the heartbreaking loss or lose in the Game 2 of the 2024 PBL All-Filipino Conference Final, the Flying Titans for a bridesmaid finished for the second straight time. But Rondina knew they had no reason to feel ashamed after putting up such a valiant effort. World Cup captain Melly Bright has been recalled to the England squad for the first time since October after recovering from a knee injury. Bright, 30, who led England the World Cup finals last summer, has missed over 5 months of the season but is named in manager Sarina Wiegman 24-player squad for their Euro 2025 qualifiers. She is joined in the squad by uncapped Chelsea team mate Aggie Beaver Jones, 20, who comes for in striker Rachel Daly after she announced her retirement from international football in April. Beaver Jones has had a breakout season for Chelsea, scoring 11 goals in 15 Women's Super League matches. The England under-23 forward earned a call-up to the senior squad as a late replacement for the injured Chloe Kelly for February 7-2 friendly victory over Austria but did not play. Wiegman has also named the standby list, which includes Manchester United's Maya Lee Tissier, Liverpool's Missy Bookerns, Southampton's Kyla Rendell and Tottenham Jess Nass. F- featured stories. Thanks to a new series starring Michael Douglas, Franklin is enjoying a renaissance, but as Eric Weiner discovers, the printers, publishers, and diplomat was also a consummate traveler. Benjamin Franklin is enjoying something of a renaissance, not that he fully faded from view, how could be, given that his visage graces the $100 bill, two-thirds of which calculate outside the U.S. Last year, director Ken Burns released a two-part documentary about Franklin. Now the founding father is the subject of a new series, Franklin, on Apple TV, starring Michael Douglas. The 8-episode series, which concludes on 17th May, chronicles Franklin's secret mission to France during the American War of Independence. Franklin's enduring appeal is understandable. He achieved so much, it's hard to know where to begin. He was the most famous American of his time, and the only founder who would have been famous even if there had never been a Revolutionary War. Franklin was a printer, publisher, satirist, scientist, diplomat, inventor, postmaster, debunker, and enthusiast. He was also a consummate traveler, journeying farther and longer than any other American of his time. My resume is considerable less impressive than Franklin's. I have invented nothing, founded nothing. I am not the most famous American of my time. I have won no wars, signed no declarations, and Michael Douglas has ever portrayed me. Sergio Palomo, an 81-year-old hiker, had always dreamed of conquering the Philippine highest peak, Mount Apo, at least once in his lifetime. But climbing Apo, which means the grandfather of all Philippine mountains, is not an easy feat due to its terrain and its height to 2,954 meters. But Palomo, an architect, challenged himself and successfully set foot on Mount Apo's summit over the weekend. Palomo is the second oldest man to successfully climb up Mount Apo and oldest to climb via the Santa Cruz Circuit Trail. And for the side stories, let's watch this. Thank you. For the trivia, do you know that Davao City is known for its tight-knit and diverse communities? Davao City embraces cultural diversity and fosters a sense of unity among its residents. That's all our news for today. Please like, share, subscribe, and click the bell button for you to be updated of the Pinoy Arab News Channel's activity. This is Gilbert Lopez Martihe-Catso. Good morning.